नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभाम् नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम। इस समय हमारे साथ उपस्थित सभी दर्शकों और भक्तों का मैं प्रेम एवं आशीर्वाद सहित स्वागत करता हूं। I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis sitting with us all over the world at this moment through Nityananda TV, Lotus TV, Sadhana TV and Ishwar TV and two-way video conferencing having Nayana Diksha. Cities sitting with us in two-way video conferencing having Nayana Diksha. Los Angeles, Guadalupe, Oklahoma, San Jose, Dharma Fest, Guru's Gate, Kuala Lumpur, Ohio, Oklahoma, Mulund, Mumbai, St. Louis, New York, Auckland, Singapore, Auckland, New Zealand, Paris Home Temple, Tondayarpet, Oman Sivagangai, Jorpati, Nepal, Ajka, Hungary, Melbourne, Australia, New Jersey, Omkareshwar, Colorado Springs, USA, Guru's Gate, California. Yes, that's it. I welcome all of you with my love and blessings. And blessings to all the participants in the Dharma Fest, Norwalk, Los Angeles. My blessings to all of you. Let the Dharma Fest be successful. Blessings. In Hyderabad, Pradyumna Reddy's place, Sangha is conducting enriching tattva session. Blessings for that. Blessings. Yes. I'll move to today's satsang. First of all, I want to thank all the devotees who are showering this get well message in Facebook and through the phone calls to our enriching temple, and the amount of suggestions and wishes. Thank you, thank you, thank you for all the love. And I also request, enough, please stop it now because my Facebook is full, my wall is full, and enriching temple is not able to handle. I just wanted to tell you guys, I think most of you, especially devotees who are watching through Sadhana TV, doesn't know what is happened to my hand. Around 2 years before, I had a fracture during the horse riding. So that time doctors have fixed plates and screws, two big plates and 15 screws. And now we did surgery and removed those screws and plates because bone got healed completely. Bone got settled completely. That's all has happened. I did not have any injury, don't worry. Just wanted you guys to know that. I'm doing well. and I am continuously taking care of my health. I am not disrespecting my health or the body. I am doing my regular activities, no doubt. I am not just sleeping. I am doing my regular shooting. The reality show which I am doing in Tamil TV, Tandi TV, I am continuing my shooting in the daytime and my morning satsang. But I don't have any problem. I am taking care of my health. I am properly resting in the night. So many people advising me, you do not take care of your health, as if taking revenge on me. Be very clear, I am very balanced guy. I care for my health, so you don't need to worry about it. And I am taking care of my health just to enrich all you guys. Just for that I will be available, so don't worry. And I am also okay. I am able to do all my movements, hand movements. And of course, it may take few more days to have all the normal movements, but I am okay. I am able to do it. I wanted to thank all the devotees and all the disciples. For showering your love and wishes. Enriching temple people are telling me that so many phone calls, they have to explain what happened from the beginning. So now I think all of you are clear about whatever has happened. And I am also sending my blessings to Vancouver, Bhuvaneshwar, the Sangha get together and bhajans and sharing session, enriching session. Blessings. Great. Today I'll expand on deeper truths of responsibility and enriching. Please listen, dhyan se suniye. Come to the space of listening. Responsibility. Among these four tattvas, integrity, authenticity, responsibility and enriching, responsibility is the most easiest principle. You don't need to do anything, a very simple thing. Whenever you are going to eat, just declare with integrity, authenticity, responsibility and enriching, I am allowing this food to enrich me, and I commit I will enrich the people who shared this food with me. When you are about to sleep, declare with integrity, authenticity, responsibility and enriching, I declare I will be complete with all my day-to-day activities and I will rest in peace. No incompletions. You will have dreamless sleep. When you wake up, declare with integrity, authenticity, responsibility and enriching, I am up. I'll hold my responsible space for the world. I tell you, responsibility is the most easiest method and process or technique. Well, you know, for responsibility to become part of you, you just need to do more and more number of declarations. Nothing else. Nothing else. In Vaishnava tradition, there's a beautiful sloka, Yasya Smarana Matrena Janma Samsara Bandhanat Vimuchyate Namastasmai Vishnave Prabha Vishnave. Means just by remembrance who liberates us. In Shaiva tradition, தர் இஸ் அ வேர்ட், நினைக்க முக்தி தரும் அண்ணாமலை. ப்ளீஸ் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் வாட் வைஷ்ணவ ட்ரெடிஷன் சேஸ் எஸ்ய ஸ்மரண மாத்திரேன, மீன்ஸ் ஜஸ்ட் பை ரிமம்பரன்ஸ் லிபரேஷன். வாட் சைவ ட்ரெடிஷன் சேஸ், ஜஸ்ட் பை ரிமம்பரன்ஸ் லிபரேஷன் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி இஸ் தட். வித் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி ஆல் யூ நீட் டு டூ இஸ் ஜஸ்ட் டிக்ளரேஷன்ஸ், just declarations. The more and more number of times you remember, more and more number of times you declare, more and more number of times you remember, more and more number of times you declare, responsibility becomes part of your being. I tell you, continuously declaring, 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 again and again and again and again, declaration. When you are eating, declare. When you are about to sleep, declare. When you are sitting, declare. When you start your activities, declare. When you end your activities, declare. Whatever you do, bring declaration. The conscious remembrance is the way to cognitive shift. Conscious remembrance is the way to cognitive shift. Conscious declaration is the way for responsibility. Please understand, when you declare again and again, your being gets awakened, your cognition gets transformed. Please listen. When you bring responsibility into your being, your non-mechanical parts of the brain gets awakened. If you are a cook and you are cooking with the responsibility that only if you cook you will have money, that with that money only you can take care of your needs and your family, you may be a good family man, you may be a head of a family, you may be a good cook, nothing more than that. But the same job, if you do with the cognition of I'll enrich the world with the food, I am responsible for the whole world. So this cooking and enriching the world is the immediate action I will do, but I am responsible for the whole world. Just a shift in your cognition, I tell you, you will be karma yogi. Because innumerable right things will be added to your thinking, innumerable right things will be added to your being, innumerable right things will be added to your action, innumerable right things will be added to your life. Innumerable right things will be added to your life. Innumerable right things will be added to your thinking. Please understand, only one thing you need to feed into human consciousness. Like if car has to move, you have to feed fuel into it. Same way, only one thing you need to feed into human being is responsibility. If just the responsibility is fed into the human being, human consciousness, everything happens. If the responsibility is not fed, nothing can be done. I tell you. Now, as a Mahamandaleshwar of the oldest apex body of Hinduism, I am looking into the reason for why we have degraded, why our civilization lost respect. Because we forgot one thing, feeding responsibility to human beings. I'm surprised, it's like a, when I look a little deeper, I could see. It is not that worker steals from the company, owner is stealing from the company. The department head steals from the department. I feel we have become like a bunch of kleptomaniacs. Now really, when we behave irresponsibly, please understand, when I am talking, when I am saying we, I am doing self-criticism. I am talking about all of us. I am not talking about somebody else. Somehow, unfortunately, we ourselves did not develop trust over our own system. We ourselves did not feel our system is capable of keeping us alive. Our system is capable of keeping us in the best form we can exist. We don't trust our system can feed us. We don't trust our system can keep us in shape. We don't trust our system can help us to excel. First thing human beings need to know, especially the leaders of Hinduism, our system is worthy. Our system can keep. Our system is intelligent enough to keep us excelling. It can make us excel. It can keep us in shape. It can keep us in peak. Feeding responsibility. Please listen. Feeding responsibility is the first step. When you don't take the responsibility, even if forts are built, it will become empty. Oh India, you can never be fulfilled with your jeans and cell phone because you are not made for it. You can be fulfilled only with your seeking, with your inner strength, with your enlightenment, with your enlightenment experience. Feeding responsibility into individual. Please understand, sometime just some part of you do not understand your responsibility, you land up in a big mess and big soup. I have seen some of very good people coming to me and saying, Swamiji, I don't know how I did that crime. Just few days I forgot my responsibility and I have landed in the soup. I am not the guy who will do that kind of a crime. I do not know who hypnotized me, who mesmerized me to do that crime. Please understand, any part of you, you have not filled with responsibility, will naturally be filled with a cognition of social excitement. Whatever society teaches you as excitement, that will become part of your cognition. You really may not wanted to do that at all. I have seen some people come to me, the Sarvadarshan, and tell, Swamiji, I never wanted to do this crime of beating up somebody or throwing stone on bus, damaging public property. But somehow I became irresponsible. I did not feel responsible for that few days. The excitement which society teaches as excitement got into my system. I did it. Now I am suffering in the court case and all the legal problems. One fellow came and told me, Swamiji, I am not even a smoker. I don't smoke. I don't use alcohol. Somehow, because my friend said, I went and sold some drugs. Because of the excitement, I am not the guy who will do this kind of work. Just the excitement, I did it. Now I am in a big legal mess. Please understand, the solution for this kind of problem is, feed yourself with responsibility. Your being should be filled with responsibility. Your being, when you fill your being with responsibility, you will understand why this thinking happened, why you got into this mess. And I tell you one more important thing. Whenever you understand and complete with the reasons why you got into this mess, all the side effects and after effects of that mess in your life melts away miraculously. Please understand, here I am giving you a promise. Here I am giving you a commitment. Don't think, now I understand, now I will bring responsibility, now I will complete. But how can this get me out of the past mess I created, happened in my life? Don't worry, here I am giving you the commitment. When you bring responsibility now and start making your being responsible, even the past suddenly melts down. Suddenly it melts down. Because your life is not disconnected from past and future. Past, present and future, all are one and the same. When you handle any one part with intelligence, when you handle any one part and complete, align, all the other parts also starts getting aligned. When you complete with your present and hold the right space for the future, the past mess just melts down. Sometime when you apply this principle, whatever right things happen in your life, you may think, I am causing that miracle. I am telling you, no. It is the power of this principle. And I will also tell you very clearly when I am causing miracle. I am not the guy who will hide. I am not the guy who will cause a miracle and then say, no, I am not causing. I am telling you very clearly. I am very straightforward guy. I know where I am causing miracle. And I know where the principle is causing miracle. I tell you, this principle itself is powerful enough to cause miracle. Where I'll cause miracle, you know, you try to follow this principle, but you are not able to, you are failing. But you are very, really, really sincere. You wanted to follow this principle because I am telling you, then even if you are not completely following the principle, I'll interfere and cause miracle. I do that. But this principle itself is intelligent enough to cause miracles. The principle itself is intelligent enough to cause miracles. Just start living this principle of responsibility. And I tell you, life has no shortcut. Sometimes people ask me, why do good people suffer? Why bad people are rich and happy? It's all lie. Life is just. Life is dharma. Whatever you want, you are having it. Whatever you want, you are creating it. Whatever you want, you are projecting it. Whatever you want, you are making it. Whatever you want, you are living it. Life is just. Life is dhamma. Life is just. Life is dhamma. Life is just and life is dhamma. So please listen. The whole life functions based on the principles of integrity, authenticity, responsibility, and enriching. If you think some part of life is wrong, still you have not started understanding that part of the life. That's all. Nothing else. If you have questions, you have to contemplate, not create anger or vengeance. Creating anger or vengeance is not going to solve the issue. Creating anger or vengeance is not going to clear it. Bring responsibility into your being. When you bring responsibility into your being and you complete with the present, please understand, I am giving you the gist. When you bring responsibility into your being and you complete with your present, the past mess happened in your life also completely dissolves, disappears. You are liberated. You are free, not only from the mistake you did, from the very pattern of doing that again. See, if there is some part of your being not filled with responsibility, if there is some part of your being not filled with responsibility, that part gets excited just by the social excitement. What is social excitement, you know? Giving you the false pseudo feeling. All the people who excite you are going to be there with you forever. When you are in mess, you will be all alone. That is what is social excitement. I tell you, people who excite you, come on, throw a stone on the bus. Come on, go and beat that guy. Come on, go and steal that chain. Come on, go and rob that house. Come on, go and sell this drug and take money. Come on, go and hit this fellow from behind the back. All this social excitement. Come on, go and rag your junior. In India, that ragging is a big problem. In India, ragging and selling drugs among the youngsters, especially in the residential schools, have become big racket. It is becoming big racket. India is facing a big danger in ragging and drugs, these two. These are all social excitement. But when you are in a mess, you will be all alone. Nobody will be there around you. Please understand, life itself is a social excitement. Society says, come on, get married. Come on, have children. Come on, have job. When you are old and all alone facing the life, nobody will be there with you. When the death comes, you will be all alone. Nobody will be there. You can't hide behind your wife's pallu. When Yama comes, understand? When Lord of Death comes, you cannot hide behind your wife's pallu and say, oh, whole world gets married, whole society lives like that only, I also lived like that. No. Kala's eyes will burn the pallu and you together. No. Society itself, I think, kind of a collective excitement which takes you away from integrity, authenticity, responsibility and enriching. I tell you, the man who understands with integrity, authenticity, responsibility and enriching, society is nothing but collective excitement and it will not stand by you when you are in a mess. Is a sannyasi. Who understands, I have to be integrated, I have to be responsible, I have to be authentic, I have to be enriching. I can't flow just because the whole group is excited to flow in certain direction. Is a sannyasi. Yes, everyone gets married, no doubt. Everyone gets the kids, no doubt. Everyone gets the properties, no doubt. Everyone cheats others, no doubt. Just yesterday, one of my sannyasi was asking me, Swamiji, even our own devotees are saying, how can we follow integrity in the business? In business, we have to be little this side, that way. That's the way we can make money. I said, no. It's a wrong trend. People say it is not practical to follow integrity in the business. No. I tell you, not following integrity and making the money, maybe the social excitement. It's like a college excitement. All these college boys, when they gather together, they throw stone on some bus. And do some strike, burn something. Behave irresponsibly. But when police catches you, you will be all alone. They will all run away. They will all disappear. Same way, because everyone in the society lives without integrity, and they do business without integrity. If you do, when life catches you, you will be all alone. Life catches everyone, understand. Country may not have enough police to catch everyone, but life has enough of Yamadutas. Yama has enough of Yamadutas to catch everyone. Understand, do not violate these principles, break these principles of integrity, authenticity, responsibility, and enriching. Even if whole world violates these principles, even if the whole world is against these principles, don't, I tell you. Because life has no shortcut. Life is straight. Please understand, sometime life attends to big, big things you did and then comes slowly, slowly, one by one to small things you do. If you have done the big crime, life first attends to it. Then comes to second, third, fourth. And the immediate actions you are doing. Because life is not attending to your immediate actions immediately, don't think life is dead. Sometime you think if you are doing a crime today and immediately punishment doesn't come, the system does not exist. No. System is very much alive. I tell you, bringing responsibility into your being is the best way to raise yourself to the next level of consciousness. And when you bring responsibility into your thinking, even the past mess in which you are caught melts down and you are free. You will be liberated. चार तत्वों में उत्तरदायित्व सबसे आसान तत्व है. आपको और कुछ नहीं करना है, बस कोई भी कार्य करने से पहले एक घोषणा कीजिए कि आप पूर्णत्व में हैं. जैसे खाने से पहले स्वयं को एक घोषणा कीजिए कि मैं उन सभी लोगों को लाभान्वित करूंगा जो मुझे इस आहार देने में भागीदार है. सोने से पहले पूर्णत्व की घोषणा कीजिए. जितने अधिक बार आप घोषणा करते हैं, उतना अधिक उत्तरदायित्व आपके अस्तित्व का भाग बन जाता है. सचेत स्मरण स्वयं आप में उत्तरदायित्व को जागृत करता है. उत्तरदायित्व आपके दिमाग के गैर यांत्रिक भागों को जागृत करता है. उदाहरण रूप, जब आप खाना पकाते हैं, यदि आप ये स्मरण करते हैं कि आपके खाना पकाने के कार्य द्वारा आप पूरे विश्व को लाभान्वित करने का उत्तरदायित्व उठा रहे हैं, आपके खाने पकाने का इस कार्य और उसे जुड़ा हुआ आपका गुण परिवर्तित हो जाएगा. पहली बात जो मनुष्य को जानना चाहिए और वो यह है कि मनुष्यों को केवल एक ही चीज खिलाने की आवश्यकता है और वो है उत्तरदायित्व. उत्तरदायित्व के बिना शेष सभी अनुपयोगी है. भारत की शक्ति है उसकी आध्यात्मिक शक्ति, जीवन मुक्ति का अनुभव. आज भारत में इस बोध की कमी बहुत ही चिंताजनक है. जब आपका कोई भी भाग उत्तरदायित्व से नहीं बारा हुआ है, आपका वो भाग सामाजिक उत्साह देने वाले किसी वस्तु से भर जाएगा. इस प्रकार की समस्या का समाधान एक ही है, अपने पूरे अस्तित्व को उत्तरदायित्व से भर दीजिए. अंडरस्टैंड, Don't go with the flow of the society always, even if you know you are wrong. Many times people do that. Just go with the flow of the society. Understand? Many times when you go with the flow, thinking, going with the flow is right, even though your integrity, authenticity does not allow you to do that. You have to answer to life. Life is not going to leave you. It will hold your collar, it will hold your neck, and you are answerable to your actions, which you did, actions which you are supposed to do and you did not do. What you did and what you are supposed to do, you did not do. For both, you are answerable. Till then, it will be a pain. Pain not just on your neck, pain on your head. Essence of today's satsang: bring responsibility. Bring responsibility into your being. Bring responsibility into your being. That is the best way to expand your being. When you don't have responsibility in your being, all your actions are only karma bhoga. When you bring responsibility in your being, all your actions are karma yoga. Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 08027279999. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.